Éire is the land of puppy farms, rain-soaked holidays, dingy bars, drugs mule celebs, verbal diarrhea, and squeaky fiddles. That fool Bob Geldof comes from there. A country where the burglars from Britain with surnames like Kettle and Rafferty return to build eyesore palaces in rat holes like Rathkeel, a small Irish town swollen by the proceeds of crime. Éire is bankrupt, yet replete with EU white elephants, many unfinished as the money dried up to complete motorways and other infrastructure. The country's banking history is a joke, wasted away on a property boom and buying in furniture restoring old British castles for narcissistic Irish entrepreneurs. Éire's history is basically British. Before that, it was a bunch of warring families and a corrupt church involved in an incessant spiral of gobshiting and slaying. Certainly not a nation. The best things in Éire are all British. Amongst them, Cadbury's chocolate, Jack Charlton, and the English breakfast. Even their much-heralded patron saint was a Brit, and they had to kidnap the poor fellow. Britain is far and away Ireland's biggest trading partner, accounting for 50% of exports from the Republic. Ireland is virtually entirely dependent upon its larger neighbour for energy, importing 90% of its oil and more than 90% of its gas from the UK. The Southern Irish, just like their northern friends Sinn Féin, can be trusted about as far as one can throw them. Nothing has changed. The Irish government, under its latest lippy Taoiseach, Leo Varadkar, continues the Irish tradition of being bloody difficult. Varadkar sees Brexit as an opportunity to be a pain in the sit upon. He has said the country will not design a border for the Brexiteers. As his foreign minister said, there was no proposal to make the Irish Sea the new frontier with the UK after withdrawal. If Britain wants to, it can run Éire into the ground, where there are no consolations. Its spotty youths will brain drain again to the US and Britain, and its economy will crumble. In a decade, after some bumps in the road, Britain and the north of Ireland will flourish. Varadkar will be on the political scrap heap like sturgeon. Maybe then prodigal Éire will seek membership of the UK. Unlikely. Unless they somehow, miraculously, developed loyalty. We'd not actually want them or their hurdy-gurdy.
The editor of Country Squire magazine says, not with tongue-in-cheek as far as I can gather, the fake ads headline in the Sunday Times will be addressed by our solicitor when he returns from a family holiday in the Algarve. I'm off fishing this afternoon and shall raise my hip flask to Ireland from my boat. It must be a slow news month in Ireland. Let's hope a cat gets stuck up a tree or something.
Right, well, look.
That's the whole tone of it. Another